You're watching WPBF 25 News, first at 4.
Hunting someone to rob. That's how one of the two people charged with killing a former Jupiter medical researcher in Baltimore described their motive. Good afternoon. I'm Felicia Rodriguez.
And I'm Tiffany Kenny. Investigative reporter Terry Parker has the charging documents in this case that is causing outrage across the country. She has live coverage from our studio. Terry, what have you learned?
Tiffany, the charging documents against this couple reveal they went out in the streets of Baltimore looking for a victim, hunting down someone to rob.
Baltimore police arrested the two suspects inside this apartment building a short distance from the crime scene. According to the charging documents, Lavella Wagner told police she and John Wagner went out that night hunting for someone to rob. Police say they found 23-year-old Stephen Pitcairn's Coach wallet and his iPhone inside the apartment. Police also found blood and several knives. Pitcairn, a medical researcher working at Johns Hopkins University, was talking to his mother in Jupiter when police say the pair robbed and stabbed him to death.
He was a big walker. He walked everywhere. He was walking back to his apartment, and he always felt safer being on the phone. So he called me and said, "Hey, Mom, I'm walking back. Do you mind if I talk to you?" I'm like, "Heck no, talk to me. Take a cab. Don't walk." But he wanted to walk.
John and Lavella Wagner both have extensive criminal records. Wagner has been convicted of assault and robbery, but has not served jail time beyond time served, even after being convicted of violating the terms of his probation repeatedly. The prosecutor's office defended itself on questions on why Wagner was still on the street.
In every instance, we sought a remedy from the court to impose additional jail time. Ultimately, the decision to incarcerate or to commit someone for these infractions is up to the judge. And in this case, that was not done.
According to the charging documents, both Wagners told wildly conflicting stories about what happened during the attack. The Baltimore prosecutor's office says it is seeking to hold the two suspects without bail until their first court appearance. Terry Parker, WPBF 25 News.